Today we are going to conduct an experiment with this equipment. This is the experiment name is measurement of screw thread parameters using two wire method by floating carriage micrometer. This setup it is called as floating carriage micrometer. So even we can able to measure the thread parameters by using three wire also, but today let us measure the thread parameters by using two wires. Especially why we are using two wires to measure the effective diameter, or it is also called as pitch diameter. Of course here we are not only effective diameter, here we are also measuring a maximum diameter of the thread as well as minimum diameter of the thread and effective diameter. So totally we are here measuring three parameters of a thread. Here you see we have taken some of course for this the aim of the experiment is to determine major, minor and effective diameter of a given thread specimen using floating carriage micrometer. And the apparatus required for this particular experiment is, this is what the floating carriage micrometer setup. I will explain it in the experimental part. And what other devices we require, it is what a standard, it is called as mandrel, right, standard cylinder it is. And these two are the wires, so best wires, these are called as best wires, okay, and to measure the effective diameter. And this is, these two are triangular prisms, right? So that is okay. And now these are all the apparatus we are having. Now let us move on to the this experimental part. You see it has got two floats, one is the bottom one and another is the top one. So here in this particular, between these two centers, we are going to mount the specimen, okay, whose thread parameters has to be measured. And this has got a micrometer, okay, so drum type micrometer. This is a thimble which is having 250 divisions, that is for one rotation it is going to cover 250 divisions. The least count of this particular thimble is 0.002 mm, and this is the vernier scale which is having 10 divisions. The least count of this vernier scale, it is also again 0.0002 mm, okay. So with the help of these two, we are going to measure the major diameter, minor diameter as well as effective diameter, okay. It has got two floats. So you see, when we are going to, I will show you, this is a specimen what we are using to measure the thread parameters, okay. This is a threaded plug gauge, okay. So threaded plug gauge, here we are going to mount the specimen, okay. Now you see, when we are going to mount it, this is the axis of the specimen. To that axis, the axis of the micrometer will be exactly perpendicular. Now you see this floats like this way to measure the diameter, and also this can flow along the axis. This is the fiducial indicator which is used to create a constant pressure throughout its experiment. Okay, so because if you are supplying more pressure for the equipment, this component, even this anvil of this micrometer can be damaged. Even this component threads can also be damaged. That's why to maintain a constant pressure, we are using this fiducial indicator. Now you see, before placing this component, we need to set it for some standard. Okay, this is the mandrel, which is having a particular 20 mm standard diameter. We can measure it by using a vernier caliper. It's a standard 20 mm diameter standard. Now we are going to place it here. Okay, so now you see, so I'm going to move this fiducial indicator. See, we can have the two floats as I told. Now you see, I'm going to set it for 20 here, because I know this even in place of this one. So instead of this one, we can use 20 mm slip gauge also. So 20 mm it is there. Let us set it for 20 mm, okay, right. Now it is 20 mm. So right, by setting it for 20 mm, I'll move this one. Next I am going to move the fiducial indicator. Okay. See? Just observe the pressure and tighten it by the help of some other, okay, because a single person cannot do these two operations simultaneously. Okay, now the pressure is here. Okay, we have to maintain a constant pressure throughout the measurement process. Okay, now I am going to release this one. Okay, now this is the standard, the 20 meter I have set it here. Okay, now I am going to remove this one. Instead of this standard, I am going to place the thread, okay, specimen whose major diameter, minor diameter as well as effective diameter has to be measured. For measuring major diameter, now I am going, okay, now you see, I have placed the, see here, just observe here, this is the standard, okay, mandrel, okay, that has got a pi, that is a diameter 20 mm. Now, this is what the maximum diameter, minimum diameter, and in between that, this is the effective diameter. Now you see, for measuring the major diameter, we are going for these two sketches. See, R1 is the reading over the standard. Standard though, what is that diameter? Standard diameter is also 20 mm. Now we have set the micrometer, whatever we have got, that will be R1. The standard diameter D is 20. Now R1 also we have got 20. R2, now we are going to measure by using the component, okay. Now you see, I want to move this one. See, observe here and observe the pressure over there. Now I got the pressure because it is having a constant pressure, contact pressure also it is. Now here we need to observe the reading. Now it is showing 15.5. So 15.5 is the what? Reading is showing. Okay, for major diameter, I am going to write a major diameter. So, right, first reading is 15.5 plus. Now, you see, in the thimble scale, how much it is showing? 0.3 and 0.3 plus 0.002, next division. After that, third division is there. 4th revision. So 0.3, we can write it here, 0.3 plus 0.002, the least count of that one. Now how much it is? 0.302 plus. Now you see here, any one of the division here will be coinciding with this one. So according to me, this is the coinciding, okay? 8 into 0.002 mm. So this is what the reading of this R2. Now 15.5 plus, now we can write it here, 0.302 0.0016, that is this one. Now how much it is there? 0.3036. Now how much it is there? 15.8036 mm. So this is what the R2 reading over the here, whatever I have shown here. Now for getting the major diameter, you see here, there is a formula is there. So major diameter D1 is equal to, this is the what, D plus R1 difference of R2, right? So now you see here, it will be always plus or minus will be there. Now D maximum is equal to, why this plus or minus? If you have taken the standard more than the component diameter, we need to take it as minus. If the standard is smaller than the component outer radius, then we need to take plus. Now in this case, we have to take minus. D maximum is equal to, so D minus R1 difference of R2. Here it is D maximum is equal to, so D is 20 mm standard, R1 is also 20, minus R2 is how much? 15.8038. Now you see, after this measurement of major diameter, now let us move on to the measurement of minor diameter of this screw thread, okay? For this one, we are having the arrangement, the same arrangement You see here, we are going to use these two triangular prisms. So these two are isosceles triangular prisms. See here, and this is an altitude. So which is of, there will be two prisms, triangular prisms. One triangular prism altitude is 4.209 mm and this one is 4.301 mm. Okay, these are standards which are given on the by the supplier. Okay, you see here, and after this we have to place this altitude, this corner, right, which is this one. So that should be placed within the thread, and again, so this opposite. Okay, you see, the indication is here we need to hold our this thumb. Okay, and opposite to this one here, you see the flat surface is there. Opposite to in that flat surface, whatever the corner it is there, that has to be apex is there, that has to be placed inside the threads. Again, opposite thread, this has to be placed. Okay, now just I am going to rotate this one, this micrometer, right? Afterwards, what I am going to do, I am going to place this one inside this thread. Okay, so and again another another triangular prism should be placed in the anvil of the this fiducial indicator. So it should be supported by fiducial indicator. Then I am going to rotate this one. Now you see, so I am going to set it for the same pressure what I did for the measured angle. Now I am going to take the reading here in the okay. So now you see here how to take this reading. First you just see this one. This is the two triangular prisms. This is the altitude of one triangular prism, that is 4.209, and this is the another one, 4.301 mm. Okay, the arrangement is like this, right? I am going to show you. Just see here. So you know, just see this sketch. So when these two prisms are placed on the standard, right, this is a theoretical method of getting this dimension, that is called as R3, because you see standard, this is a mandrel which is having 20 mm diameter, and these two we know that 20 plus 4.209 plus 4.301, there you are going to get R3 directly without the experiment, without doing the experiment. Okay, so you see here 4.209 and 4.301. After that, these two prisms are placed within the threads in the opposite grooves, right? Now there we are going to get the R4 by the micrometer. Okay, so that is what after the experiment we are going to get it. Now let us go for R4 calculation. Now you just see here R4. R3 is equal to what I told, that is 20 plus 4.209 plus plus 4.301. So that is what after the addition you are going to get it. And R4 we need to get it in the micrometer. Just see here, 24.24 and 1. Just see the main scale, all right? 20, 21, 22, 22.5 in the main scale, plus just observe here, point that is 0.24, you write it down, 0.24 plus, just see, 1, 2, 3, that is 3 into 0.002 plus, just see that coinciding here, so it will be around here, that is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 into 0.0002. This is what the R4 reading. Okay, now after this calculation, okay, after taking the reading with these two triangular prisms, now let us move on to the calculation of D minor, that is a minor diameter of the thread. This is the D, that is a standard, that is 20 mm, already we know it. And this is what the R3, that is when the two triangles are placed on the thread. You see here, the sketch it is there, here it is, R3 it is there. And R4 is when the two triangular prisms are placed over the thread. That is what the R4, that reading is shown here. Okay, so R4, that is what we have taken the reading in the micrometer, and this is what the calculation formula. D actually it will be plus or minus. When it is plus or minus, when we have to take it is as a plus, when the standard will be taken, when that diameter is more than the diameter of the measuring thread, then here we need to take plus. But here we have taken 20 mm, that is more than the thread to be measured. That's why we have to take minus here. R3 is 28.51 and R4 is this one. After the experiment, what we have got it. And after the calculation, this is what the D minor diameter of the thread. Okay. So after knowing this major diameter and minor diameter, now let us move on to the measurement of effective diameter of this particular thread. Now, before going to measure the effective diameter, we have to know what is effective diameter. Okay. You see here, effective diameter is that imaginary diameter of a thread where the width of the thread, that is, and this one from here to here, and the gap between the two threads will be same. On the flanks, if you take this distance from here to here, as well as this gap from here to here, it will be same. Like that in the opposite also. And that the diameter between these two pitch lines, actually these lines are called as pitch lines, the diameter between these two pitch lines will be called as effective diameter or D effective. Okay, here to measure the D effective diameter, now let us move on to this one. Okay, we have to use here we are using two wire method. Also we can use it, we can measure it by three wire method, but for here we are using two wires. It is called as best wire. Okay, one is this one and another is placed here. Two wires, right? Oppositely, in the opposite thread profiles, these two wires are placed. The thread, this wire diameter will be, this is standard, it will be 0.620 mm. That is called as best wire size. So now you see, if you place these two wires, right, on the standard. Now what is this R5 now? Then R5 is, standard is 20 mm plus this one is 0.620 plus 0.620, that is 20 plus 2 into 0.620, that is what? So here I am going to show you. So effective diameter, sorry, here it is. So that is what R5. And R6 is when these two wires are placed within the profile, thread profiles, right, two wires. Then if you take the reading over the micrometer, then that will be R6. This value, R6 value, we have to get it by the measurement process only. But for this R5, theoretically we can get it because we know the diameter of the standard and we know the diameters of these two wires. That is 20 plus 2 into 0.620 is R5. I'll show you here. R5 is equal to, so 20 standard plus 2 wires, 0.620. So that is what R5. After the calculation, we are going to get it R5. And R6 is what? After the experiment, we are going to get it R6 by this micrometer. Now, to measure R6, that is effective diameter, we need to use two wires. Here you see, these two wires, best wires, 0.620. Both the wires are 0.620 only. It is pre-calibrated. And now you see, I am going to remove this threads, this prisms, okay, right, I am going to move this one, right, I am going to remove this, in place of that triangular prisms, it is very similar, and we are going to use these wires. One wire will be, you see here, I am going to place it here, right, so in the opposite wire will be placed in the, so opposite groove, okay, now you see. First, I am going to place it here because I am going to rotate this. I can rotate this micrometer. Opposite will be, I am going to place it. See, in this groove, I am going to place it, and in the opposite, by the rotation of this,
see. Now observe the pressure here. This measuring pressure in the fiducial indicator, it should be as before what we have maintained, okay? This is the measuring pressure, okay? Now take the reading over here in the micrometer. Okay, these two wires are placed opposite to each other, okay? Right, now take the reading here. Now just see, 15.5, 16 is visible here. I'm going to take it as R6 as 16 plus, see here, 0.35 is there. So you can write it as 0.35 plus, after that, how many divisions are here? 1, 2, 3. Three divisions are there, 0.002 plus, which is the coinciding here, just observe here. Here, it will be around this line. This is the 8th line. 8 into 0.3002. That is the least count of that scale. Now I am going to calculate R6 and R5. And afterwards, I am going to put it in the, that is what the formula is there. There I am going to put this R5 and R6. Then I am going to get the value of effective diameter. Okay. So after getting the readings of R5 and R6, R5 is directly we can get it by without the experiment, because we know the standard dimension, it is 20 mm mantle dimension, and this two wires, 2 into 0.620, that is what after the calculation you are going to get it, 21.24, that is mm, and R6 after the experiment or measurement we are going to get R6, that is in the micrometer already we have seen 16 main scale division plus 0.35 plus 3 divisions, extra divisions are there, that into least count of that micrometer is 0.002 mm, and plus 8 vernier, there's a coinciding vernier scale divisions into 0.002. After the calculation, R6 will be 16.3576, right? After getting R5 and R6, substitute these values in the this particular equation, that is D effective, this is effective diameter, that is equal to D minus of bracket, that is R5 minus P, this is what the pitch value, minus R6, okay. This pitch value can be obtained here, the P is equal to, so this is obtained in the chart, 0.86602 into P. Pitch of this thread is 1 mm, by the pitch gauge we can, we have calculated pitch as 1 mm, minus this is what the best wire size, that is 0.620. Pitch value for this, this is the equation for metric threads. P is equal to 0.8660, that is what pitch is 1, right? After the value, we are going to get pitch value is 0.24602. Now substitute this P in this equation. Now you see 20 minus 4.63, that is D effective is equal to 15.36 mm. Effective diameter of this thread is 15.36 mm. Now we have got, so D major, that is a major diameter, minor diameter and effective diameter. Afterwards, now just compare here. Major diameter will be here, it is more, 15.8038. Effective diameter is 15.36 mm and minor diameter is 14.237 mm. So this is what the this experiment is completed and getting these three diameters.